Then we have Josh.
Josh?
I get nervous speaking in public, so bear with me.
Yes, sir.
You know, it's interesting. We started this thing before we even started. You said, you know, if you don't have to say things that were already said, don't worry about it. Well, this is the third time I've been here, so evidently we have to say it again because the first two didn't quite work. And the other thing about this, you know, I was late coming here because all the buildings that fell over from the 2009 codes, evidently. See, we have a tendency to say, well, we need these. And a gentleman last time pointed out a code. The first code in this country was written by George Washington. Well, it's interesting, you know, the first code in history was written by a king in Persia about 1700 BCE. And it's interesting, too, to note that George Washington didn't decide to use the international codes that were already in existence. I wonder why that was. Because England already had building codes, and he says, no, we are a republic. Which leads me to something else. We started with a prayer and a pledge. We took a pledge to the republic for which it stands. Do you know what a republic is? A republic is a domestically based entity governing organization of the people, which means if you vote to adopt an international building code, you therefore broke the pledge you just said 15 minutes ago. I was kind of joking when I said I don't speak well in public. I do it for a living. And I will keep doing it as long as you keep voting for things that don't make sense. And I will tell you that it's amazing how many people have spoken on behalf of this thing. Where were they again? So we need to remember, guys, when we're talking about an international building code and we're talking about codes in general, your job is to protect us from organizations outside of this county that want to abuse and use people. And it's almost getting like an episode of Maury Povich, where we hear things like, oh, well, it helps you save on insurance. Well, the results are in, and that too is a lie. So we really have to say to ourselves, what's the job? Your job is to have the insurance companies come in here then and say, you tell us why you are going to lower or raise rates on people who live here, and then make them prove it. If over 100 people have spoken before you and you don't get it yet, I think maybe next time, instead of codes that we need to replace, it might be politicians.